pretty cloudy. As you can see from the sky clock. All sky cam, excuse me. I was just looking at the sky clock. Broadcasting just to, you know, show off the sky that I'm seeing. That's it. If you enjoy it, let me know. And yeah, figured with the pretty crappy sky, you know, I'll keep an eye on it, and it's going to be periodic as far as the clearing, but I'll definitely keep imaging, because we can still see bright objects like this, and even though there's massive halos of fog, there's still quite a bit of good detail in there in a stack image. Personally, I think. We can play around a little bit. doing really well. I think I'll turn the temp down on the cooler. It's pretty cold outside right now, so it's performing pretty well. See if we can get another 5 degrees on it. I'd like to keep it around 30%. Well, it was underutilized at this point. Of course, the cooler is there to chill the CCD and lessen the effects of noise and hot pixels, that type of thing. It can't take any of that. I could probably go right up to that white line right there. That's about it before it goes. This is the vapor secondary histogram components. You know, it's the other stuff it's seeing besides this stuff. It's seeing all that water vapor, which is showing up in the histogram. It's hilarious. But still, that's a reasonably pleasing image. I like it. Get that green out. With all the haze, it doesn't take the color changes very well. So slightly adjusting, and it's so far zero that is best in my eyes. It's crappy. I don't want you to bring in too much blue. I'd rather take a little bit more blue, go a little more subtle than that, and then take away some of the reds maybe. Yeah, not that much. Start bringing it back in that. The red just kind of overwhelms. And that ends up bringing out quite a good bit of detail. Certain areas, you know. Probably tease out a little bit more lightness and detail at this point. That's 7 minutes of data, and that's data with garbage. Looks like some of those early frames were worse than what, I don't know. It's really bad right now. Look at that. That is terrible. My neighbors got all their lights on, which is awesome. It was very clear when I got home from work. But not anymore. Just the clouds are moving quickly, so whatever happens is going to be either fully cloudy or hopefully clear up. Right. So that looks nice detail-wise, but total crap. I need to darken that background. Which is good, because every time we get some data, histogram moves a little bit to the right. All this garbage here is the other side of the spectrum of that haze. So we'll pull this right on up. It's too bad. The haze ruins everything. Clouds. Can't really do much with it. But what we can do on this object, and I'm going to move around in a minute here, probably when we hit 10 or 15 minutes on this, which is going to come pretty quick, only 20 second exposures, live stacking, but we'll zoom in a little bit on some of this nebulosity, see what we get. Interested in that little bit of detail right in there. Let me do it. Full screen. You know, the way that the color is in here. Darker than that. And then you have this dust lane. Forget the blown out trapezium, you know, that comes with the territory. You can barely see the running man. Again, this is the problem of the clouds, which are now almost completely obscuring everything. We may not be broadcasting very long. Considering the amount of clouds that are visible on the all-sky cam in the bottom right of the screen for the viewer, that's pretty crazy. Chat is not available, so why is that? We that little ding that you occasionally hear is the autoguider PhD2 dinging because it's like losing the ability to guide on a star because of the lovely clouds that are overhead. Which you can see on the bottom right of your screen in the yellow sky cam, which I have visible in this scene, if you will. But we have an image of M42, looking pretty good.
Alexa, play the album Stand Up by Jethro Tull.
Stand Up by Jethro Tull on Amazon Music.
And I'm just letting Amazon play. I don't monetize these videos at this point. Of course, there's the heater. That's just a very steady rum. But you should still be able to hear my voice. So for right now, we'll just see if we can't hit this really close by. I should tell my guider, there you go, so it doesn't scream. I had to realign in the clouds, so my alignment is not really that great. But it might have gotten the right star in the field. Exposure to see, to check it out. You can see it counting down here on the bottom right. Probably going to be a wash, even at 20 seconds. Oh, terrible. And we have a really weird artifact. Thank you. light's not coming through. It's being blocked by the clouds, but we're gonna have to give it a bit of an exposure to see. The flame should be right there at the bottom, but even typically you'll see it, which is why. A little bit of hope, but that's kind of thinning out. Waiting for my exposure. Don't necessarily trust where I am in the sky. I mean, everything's pointing right there, but I'm not seeing the flame, and the flame should be like right here in the horse head right here. Or I'm off kilter. And I don't see any signs of that stuff. Because of where it is. Get my auto guiding cranking. Hopefully it's happy. It's been very finicky. Exposure, see if we can tolerate it. Set my gain to 350, which is about the top gain. mean, it actually works really well for imaging all sorts of things. Above that, you'll start to see amp glow in the corner. But right about there is, you don't see any, and it's plenty good. So I usually, you know, frame, cranking up the gain so you can see it at the object, whatever it is, at a, you know, very fast speed, you know, 1 second exposure. All right, there's our guy. M1, the Crab Nebula. Looking very red due to this kind of garbage, but it is better up there than it was. Telescope, but it's not the greatest telescope. Hence. So again, clearing up a bit, still pretty cloudy. Certainly not as good as it could be, but we'll take it. Back to that, and try to make this a little bit better. Obviously, you know, take away some of the insane red. Look at here, I can abuse it terribly. Which some objects, you could crank it right up and it wouldn't be enough. But crap is more blue. Better to have a dark sky behind it. Pull back the red. Gently introduce it back. That's probably good. And we start to see the different colorations, the purples and stuff that are really in that. With 4 minutes of data, again, it's also a tiny object. We could probably crank up the resolution here. Not something I do too often when I'm imaging with darks and flats, which I have to enable. it's a beautiful image, only going to get better as we go. Green channel, see how it responds. Yeah. It wants the green and the blue. Some more data in there, we can start to stretch it up like so. Connection, so occasionally the video output is telling me it's a bit low. That's very pretty. It's very nice. I mean, it is purple and red. At least the images I've seen from Hubble. It's got all tendrils. We're not seeing that kind of data, considering what's going on, you know, in the All Sky Cam. The haze, it's making it kind of tough. But this camera delivers in that. That's a really nice image. Really quickly. Data. It's really cool. Cleaning up nicely. Noise is disappearing, it's smoothing out. Structure is kind of slowly filling in. So it wouldn't get too much better, but it would get cleaner. Greatness here. I'll take the skies any way I can get them, believe me. Stars look good. Like I said, there's a bit of fringing, but the colors look great. Everything individual. Take a bit more magnification. So if you're alone and you're down to the bone, just give us a play. Just smile a while and discover that I'll get your hand in my way. Nothing's easy. Awesome. Yawning on camera. Alright. Well, I'm looking around. I'm trying to decide what my next target is here as we look at the sky and see the haze that's there. Still quite a few really nice options. Of course, I haven't even paid any attention to Andromeda. But on a night like tonight, it's just going to be a haze. Little dumbbell. And then there's planetary nebula. We could try some of that. Let's see what we come up with. Here. Came out pretty good. 14 minutes of data. A couple shots of it. This is drive-by astronomy in its finest. Cranking down to a reasonable speed. Crank up the gain so we can see what we're doing. The 1 second exposure, 1.8, and then we'll see if we can't find the Eskimo planetary nebula. Move the dome.
stop the birds and hens. While in the bush, the others land. Take what we can before the man said it's time to go. Each to his own way, I'll go mine. Best of luck with what you find. But for your own sake, remember time.
Getting chilly. We're about 20.
But in the warm room, or slightly warmer room, somewhere,
it's not too bad. It's probably 55, 60, not quite. I'm gonna keep the curtain closed soon. And I've got a really cool 12-volt blanket that I just got. I'm digging. Okay, we are looking now for an object. I don't know that I see it, but if I remember correctly, the alignment stinks and we need to modify and see if we can find what we're looking for.
The wind dimming light brings an end to a night of loving.
That's nothing, it can't be too small. Size of a star, you know, which is kind of how some planetaries are, like the blinking and stuff, but when you look off to the side, it's much bigger. Cool blue, but not the item in question. Faux show. Alright.
I'm just gonna, if it's not like right here, I'm gonna end up redoing my alignment because I'm not happy about that at all. Tonight's perfect, but tonight, not good. Found him. Look how far off. Ridiculous. Gotta redo the alignment after this, if there is. Alright. How bad our guiding is, as we may have to recalibrate, which will take about 3 or 4 minutes. Blanket 102. Feels looking beautiful. Feels incredible. Guiding so far seems okay, so I think we'll take the next great data, beautiful object. We're gonna hear it. And take an exposure. We'll do 60-second exposures because I'm being bold, even though it's garbage factor. Still, that's awesome. We can clean it up quite a bit. Make it much better. I hope.
We only have one image at 60 seconds. Let's not get too aggressive. Images and we get some histogram data. Not bad there. Cloudy as it was, but still pretty hazy. I got 4 minutes of data right now. They look pretty sweet. M81 and M82. I looked at this a few nights back, and they were beautiful. Yeah, they're just gorgeous. I like both galaxies and how different they are from each other. And yet how unique they each are. So cool. Structure. definitely needs more data to smooth all that out. It's only 7 minutes, you know, in a lot of haze, like a real lot. So I'm still totally always surprised by this camera, how awesome it really is, you know, cutting through like that. Beautiful structure, getting better every minute as we accumulate more and more data. Finally. Starting to get more structure in the cigar. At least I can tell that there's more in there now, of all those dust lanes and extend out. You can actually see it. And that's why accumulating data here is definitely a good thing to do. Of course, that's a 50% crop of the actual image, which has some edge issues. We'll go to 40% and enjoy it. Get that coffee coming. Piping hot, as Ron Bopeil used to say. Okay, 11 minutes worth of data. It certainly deserves more, especially considering how atrocious my alignment is. Very cool. Let that go a little bit longer. looking good. Keep getting more data. We can crunch down the sky background. Bring it all brighter in the core, and you know, which is not so great, but you end up seeing more detail in the fringes. As you can now, every accumulation, every image brings more information. And the way the haze is, I have to keep adjusting the color balance. Looking natural. Or unnatural, like that. It's a fine line, man. Still too much red in there for my liking. We can get one step above that. 98. Yeesh, that's worse. 112. Yeah. Good data there. Awesome. Slightly better positioned now than it was. Alright, so let's look back. You can often use the all sky cam to determine, you know, from in here, really what's above the tree line. Other stuff to come up. So I want to come back to Orion. Or actually, I'll take a break and try to improve my alignment. I'll be back in a few minutes.